Today on the table, we have a Tau AX10 Tiger Shark. It's a really, really, really big boy with some really, really, really big rail guns. I'm painting it up for a friend of mine. Today, I'm going to be painting this guy with a base coat of Red Scarlet from Vallejo. And then we're going to highlight it up with some Mephiston Red and some Evil Sun Scarlet. So, in a second, we'll be doing that. Alright, so today I have my Badger Sotar. It is set to between 25 and 30, depending on the consistency of the paint, PSI. And so, what we're going to do right now is we're going to mix a 1-to-1 mixture of our Red Scarlet and actually some Windex. It's a thinner I like to use, especially when I'm using an airbrush. I would definitely recommend you use a respirator when using it. And have some ventilation in your room if you're not using a spray box. So, as you can see, we're going to get about a dollop of our paint here. And then just a couple squirts of Windex into there. And what we're going to do is we're going to mix it up nice with our brush. Check our consistency there. Gonna add just a drop more paint. And so with these things, really, when you're mixing paint for an airbrush, the way I've done it is I've basically just felt it out. I kind of would load up paint in there at first so it was so thick I wouldn't be able to spray. And then I kind of just started thinning down from there in order to figure out where about the ratio was good for me. I'm guessing it'll differ a little bit for each person, but I think overall, the best way to learn is practice. So what I have here is a piece of foam from an army transport case, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to use that to prop this guy up nicely so I can get a nice easy paint. Before I start painting, there's a few parts I would like to remain black on this, as well as some details. The details aren't too bad, I can pretty much do them at the end, but for the larger engine section that I would like to stay pretty dark, especially to contrast with the glow from the engines, I'm going to use some yellow Mr. Frog's masking tape. It's very, very low tech, so you can put this on. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start laying it across. I don't have to worry about the detailing too much on the edge of the engine because I'm going to change that up. But I just want to start sticking some little sheets of this stuff down over the different parts of the engine in order to keep it nice and black for when I'm going to go over this. So I'll do that one, do a few more, and then I'm going to get this all finished up so that I can show you how we can start to base coat it. Alright, so what we're gonna do now is again we're gonna load in a little paint into our cup. Nice and careful. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna gently start feathering on a layer of Red Scarlet paint. And as you can see, I'm done masking it, and we're just gonna gently start to go over it until you see the color start to build up there. And since we started with a black base coat, I think it's actually easy if we if we're just a little bit careful here, and if we stay away from the indented areas, we can keep some of that black in the shadows. So we're just gonna work our red color nice across all the different armor plates, nice and slow. Again, and as you go, you can kind of select some of the details you think you might want to keep black. The tape lifting up a little right there, and we just airbrush through that. Alright, so we'll just keep putting down our color here. And it's definitely good ahead of time to maybe make a little plan about which armor plates you want to be which colors, because it saves you from going back over and over and over. do actually have a bunch of Minotaur paints. I ordered the whole Minotaur line, actually. I've heard a lot of good things about it. I actually really like mixing my own paints. I think it's fun. But whatever works for you. I've tried a bunch of different ones. I've tried the Vallejo Model Air. I've tried all my GW paints through my airbrush. I really like using GW paints through it. The Vallejo Model Air, I feel, is really, really prone to tip dry. So I tend to even water that down just a little bit, or thin it, well, water it or thin it, depending on. So I'm going to finish up this Scarlet, and I'll be back in just a few. Alright guys, so as you can see, we have a nice dark coat of Scarlet Red over our AX10 here. And so next up, what we're going to do is we're going to highlight that from Zenithal, the Zenith position, which is basically above. We want to make it seem like the light is shining from above in this. Well, in this case, I'm going to make it look like the light is shining from above. We're going to use Mephiston Red for that, so I have a little bit in the bottom of my cup. I'm going to hit that with a few sprays of Windex, make it a 1-to-1 ratio. Take that mixing brush. You don't want to use a good brush for this either, because Windex tends to tear your brushes apart. And it will also eat away chrome in an airbrush, so you don't want to use it in any airbrushes that have chrome anywhere. My Sotar has stainless steel, so it's not that big of an issue. So what we're going to do is we're going to load up our airbrush here with some of our Mephiston Red. And so the guns are going to be in this position, so basically I want to highlight from the top down. So I'm going to, and that looks nice and bright now, doesn't it? So I'm going to highlight just like that. Right there. Same thing on the other side. So now we got a nice ominous, and if it looks a little bright at this point, that's okay, because we're going to be going back later and darkening it down with some black lining, and then we're going to come back a second time to give it another base coat. So we're going to do the same thing on the other gun. So this one red from up top. A nice bright red. And what you want to do, what I like to do is I like to have darker plates on the outside, so what I'm going to do is hit these guys right in the middle of the armor plates with this Mephiston Red. A little overspray there, but that's alright. We'll just even it out. Sorry if I'm getting out of time, you guys. I'm trying to focus and focus on doing this well. So sometimes it doesn't work, but as you guys can see, there really are some nice bright highlights starting to go there, and I'm really sorry about the camera quality right now. I'm really just getting to know this, so load up a little more paint here. We continue on with our edging. Now you can see we've built up a nice red transition on this side. And we'll start doing some crazy bright red edge highlights. You get down in the recesses, don't really worry, just really, we're gonna really focus on cleaning that up later with our black, when we go back and hit this lining, and then once we've done our black lining, we're gonna come and we're gonna hit it with the original base color again, which is our Scarlet Red, and that's gonna tone everything down just to where we want it. So right now, as you guys can see, I'm really beginning to bring this red up fearlessly. So I'm going to hit the rest of some of these armor plates here. Alright, then, as you can see, I was just cleaning up my brush with a little bit of more Windex, and see you guys later in a bit. Alright guys, we're back. The next step will be to take some Privateer Press Thamar Black. I'm going to mix that down with some Windex, the same as I did before, creating a one-to-one. And then what I'm going to do with that is we're going to put it down into the lines of the model. We're going to basically black line it, give it some real deep shadows, and once that's done, we're going to hit it with once over with the base color, and that's really going to give us some nice definition to this whole piece. And once that's done, we're going to mask off the reds, and then we're just going to do our black detail sections, and we'll go on from there. Alright, so we have our paint mixed. Going to load up our airbrush. And you're really going to want to take your time with this step. Alright. You really want to put this paint down in the recesses. And not much other place. So, take your time. Ooh. It's not so bad. And this is a time-consuming step in a lot of cases, but it's definitely one that's worth taking your time with and not skipping, because it makes your end result much, much better. So now you can start to see that some of these black lines are much more pronounced, and what we're going to do after that is go over a coat. One more coat of our base red, which was the Vallejo Game Color Red Scarlet. So as you guys can see, I've put black lining into all and most of the recesses, and if you mess up a little bit, that's not too bad, because when you go over it with the base coat again, it'll give it a bunch of nice variation in the color. So our next step is going to be to mix up a batch of our red scarlet again and go over this guy. Hey guys, so I finished the black lining of the model, and now I've gone back and I've basically masked the parts that I wanted to stay black. I touched them up before, so they're nice, and put some really, really low-tack tape over them. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to spray the model over again with a 2-to-1 mixture of the second color, which was Mephistone Red. And so basically, just want to water that down a little bit more. Trusty Windex. So, what we're going to do now is we are going to place our model. And the thing about this step is, you really want to be gentle with how you're doing this, because you want to leave a gradient to those nice shadows you put in there, so you don't want to completely cover them up. Which is why I prefer to water the paint down a little more at this step. So, what we're going to do is we're going to start just on side over here. There we go. And we're just going to start putting our red back down in nice places. Main areas that we had before. Oh, Same. Forgot to mask these two places, so I'm gonna do that real quick. And we are good to go. So now we're just gonna continue to put down a few coats of our base Mephiston Red until you can see a really nice blend start to develop between all the colors. You'll see the blacks. The black will really start to become red, and it'll begin to just make this real nice blend across the model. Oh yes, oh yes, look at this beautiful. And then you can see that maybe in the middle of the armor plates you might want it a little bit brighter, so you can kind of focus on those areas with a little bit harder coat. And you can see with this thinned down paint, it's fairly easy to put a few really thin coats on versus one solid coat, which lets us keep all those awesome shadows we just filled in. Remember? Once you start to see the color build up, you want to ease up on how many times you're going over that particular spot. And then you want to start to hit the center much, much more of the plates. And once you get to a certain point, I even actually like to start using a little bit of a mask to stop it from going too far away from where, and actually just kind of directing the paint to other spots, if you will. And we'll just let a little bit of this Mephiston Red color build up there. See if we can keep our nice shadows in there. Oh yeah. Alright, now I can see the color is really starting to build up over here. So I'm going to begin to ease up off of it. Begin to finish up the highlights on this wing. And now, like the last step, this is actually one of those steps you want to take a little time with. You don't want to rush on this because you can get overspray, which will muck up all those nice lines you made, as I said before. So it really pays to just ease back on that paint trigger. So I'm going to lift her up now, so I can start concentrating the paint. It may take you a little bit of time, but very quickly you'll begin to see a beautiful color gradient start to build up. All the shadows that you spent your time putting down are going to pay off, because now, as you can see with this airbrush, I'll put it up close, even if I spray this red down, it's not going to fill the black lined cracks that we had before, because in order to fill those cracks you really need to get up close. And so I can feel nice and comfortable spraying a good load of paint on down here and keeping that beautiful shadow work we did. Look at that. Isn't that good? And if I could focus on a specific area, I would really try to focus on the larger section of the plate. You want to kind of, as best you can, try and stay away. And again, if you don't feel your hand is steady enough, you know, maybe try a few different positions of holding your hands. But the number one thing is practice. So you can compare the sides for yourself. You can see how the right side of this picture has our now Mephiston redded up base color, rather highlight, with the dark lined. And this side still has all the black lines, so you can see how much you're going to really tone the lines down there. And I still actually have a couple coats, maybe one more actually, to do on this side, and then it'll be done. So I'll come back when we're ready. Stay tuned! So as you guys can see now, this guy has his nice dark lines in the recesses, and that's with the... So far what we have, I guess, is we have the base of Scarlet Red over black, then we have the highlight of Mephiston Red. We went through and we put all those black lines in for a shadow, and then we went over it with Mephiston Red again. So the last and final step I'm going to do here, I have a 1-3 mix of GW's Evil Sun Scarlet, and I'm just going to spray that. It's real watered down, 1-3 mix, as I said before. I'm just going to put that right on the highlighted edges, so we have just a nice little downward shine to our red. As you can see, I'll just really want to just touch this on the highest parts of the plates where you want, where you really want some color to stand out. A little down the middle. Just an easy go over the center of these plates. Make sure you do get all of them. And make sure, with this, you want to make sure you give like a quick 2 coats per. Do the center of the plate, over once, over twice. Center the plate brights up. Center edges. Here I'm just gonna do the very edges of things. So he just really becomes a bright red there. Card that I have lying around. I like cards when I'm doing this because they have kind of nice edge and you can really kind of get them up to some of the curves even. Follow around like that. You got a little bit of hand skin. Actually, but this isn't too bad because the paint's so thin. Same thing on the opposite side.
Alright guys, now that we have our Evil Sun Scarlet down, you can see a really nice transition between our bright outer red to the inner red. If I turn it up this way, you can see the black that's under there. So now I'm going to take a quick break, and we're going to take the masking off, and we're going to start doing the touch-ups on our black details.
So at this point, my reds are mostly done. All I'm going to do now, towards the end, is go back over the model and do some edge highlights. But basically what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back and I'm going to touch up the black details that might have gotten some red on them when I was airbrushing. And so what we're going to use for that is our same Thamar Black. It has pretty nice coverage. I actually used Privateer Press for the first time the other day, and I was very, very surprised at how well their paint covered and how well it flows when you water it down. So what I'm going to do basically is take some bunch of black. Actually, I'm going to start with this piece. It looks like a nice piece to start with. So I'm going to take my black, and this is the missile rack for the undercarriage of the tiger shark. So I'm going to get some paint on our brush. Roll it off on the paper towel to get a nice point. And we're literally just gonna sweep that right across the edge. That's against the red, so we have a nice hard line there. Actually, it wouldn't be too bad to, if you're really going for a solid, solid look. See, I can pretty easily just put another layer of paint on there. Just load up your brush nicely and put on a nice thick layer of, not even thick, thin it down a nice bit, about even parts water, even parts paint, 1-1.
Just get a nice dab of it. And I'm not too worried if I'm getting actually some of the red water into the black paint, because that'll kind of cherry up the black almost. Make it a nice cherry black rather than just a black satin. So, give a little bit of life. And then you can also, if you see that some of your red paint got down into the grooves around, you can just reline that real quick. Very careful. There we go. So what I've done is basically touched up all the black parts and laid down a base coat of Eschen Gray, a GW color, on a few different details here. And I'm about to highlight those up. I've also done a couple of edge highlights with some Troll Slayer Orange. It's a very, very transparent color. It's also what I use on my own personal marines. So I know that it takes quite a while to put down. That's why it's also really good for edge highlighting. I've done Troll Slayer Orange all around the edges here, and that'll be finally brightened up by Fire Dragon Bright, and we'll do that one of the later steps. Anyway, what we're going to do next is basically we're going to take our airbrush with some Vallejo Cold Gray, which I've mixed up 2-to-1, Windex and paint, and in a second we're going to load up our airbrush, and we're going to start really doing some fine highlights on the grays and on the edges of the black. Alright? So, we're going to load up our airbrush with the cold gray. Mix it around a little bit. And drop it in. Make sure you have a nice even spray. Beautiful. And now, we're going to just go and I'm going to use a piece of cardstock to defend the edge of you. Now you see what I'm doing there? It's giving it instantly a nice bright edge. If it seems a little bright at this step, that's okay, because we're going to go back over that with some Nuln oil wash later. Be real gentle on the forward edge of the wing. You just really want to create a nice transition effect. Almost. You just want to bring the brightness out a teeny bit. So, here's our cardstock here. You want to make sure you have a nice seal on that cardstock as well, so that none of your paint goes underneath. I'm ever so gentle with my colors. As you can see, we have some nice edge highlights built up. I'll be back when I'm finished. So as you can see, the edges of our armor plates are nicely brightened up. And you have some cool transitions going on there in the grays. And that'll all get even darkened down, especially when once we hit it with that anomaly on it. At the same time I prime this white, I'm also going to begin the glow on the railguns. It's basically going to do the same thing, so we have a common glow. It'll be nice and green, glowy, and scary. Next up, I'm going to be priming the engine sections to glow. I'm going to do a green glow that's going to consist of Caliban green, Warpstone glow, and Moot green. Maybe even some white in the center. We'll see how it goes. Alright, so basically I have this taped off, and I'm going to get my white paint. For this, you don't really need to paint thin down the paint that much. You actually, for the engine glow, I kind of want it pretty thick, because I want it to actually be the base. But for the weapons, I'm actually just going to spray a little bit of white along the rail, actually where the projectile would fly out, because I want a nice base for the blue to stick onto, and that'll make the blue that I'm going to use, or green rather, come out nice and bright. So as you can see, we've made almost a mask for our tiger shark. We have our white paint. 1-to-1 mixture. What we're gonna do is we're gonna load up our brush now. And you wanna be liberal here, but you wanna make sure you keep that tape down around, because you don't wanna mess up all the other work you just spent all your time on. I'm gonna be nice and liberal. I'm really gonna get a good coat of paint in there. You want a really solid base for your green. Apologies, I'm eating a fruit roll-up. Right. And then we're gonna just do a little bit of white. Right up the center of the rail. With a little bit more concentrated towards where the beginning of the projectile would be coming out. There we go. So there you can see we have the beginning of our glow. I'm sure it'll cover up some of the stuff you've done underneath, but it'll be worth it. Now that we have our weapon glows ready to paint, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back over our gray areas and our black areas, and I'm going to start to do a little bit of edge highlighting. And for this edge highlight, I'm going to be using Vallejo Game Colors Stonewall Gray. And actually, before I even do that, I'm going to go back and touch up some of the gray areas that might have been hit a little bit with some of the white by the engine with the original cold gray. And then we'll re-highlight those up. And then after that, we're going to paint the engine glow. And we're going to have to be a little bit careful with that, because when we're doing this, we want some of the glow to leave its intended area, but we don't want to end up with this big green mess around the instead of a nice, beautiful glow.
So we're really going to thin down our paints a lot. So we can really take our time to build up this nice color. And how I'll probably start with that is once I'm done fixing up these grays, I'll go with a Caliban green that's super thin, and I'll paint that just barely outside of the edges of the engine areas. And then I'll go back with Warpstone Glow, and that'll be the base for the inside. And then Moot Green will take up a very thin line down the center, and then I'll go back and hit that with just a teeny bit of Moot Green mixed with a bunch of white to highlight it up so it really looks hot. But first, let me finish up these highlights. Alright guys, so what we're going to do here is we're going to begin our weapon glows. And so I have a very watered down mix of Caliban Green. This is about a 4 to 1 actually, mixture of Windex and Caliban Green. And load up our airbrush. As before, we want to focus on the center, but since this is the darkest glow, we want this to be our furthest reaching green. So we're just going to start in really gentle. Start to go up our center. Now we'll hit the other side a little bit. As you can see, this takes a little bit of time, but for the finished product, it'll be well worth it. Doing a little more to work the color a bit towards the edges of the barrel. I'm going to continue very, very carefully now on the engine sections. And I haven't decided whether I'm going to do the back engines a blue or green glow yet. I think I'm going to do them green to match up just because. So, now, I use my fingers as a little bit of a mask here, and I just start to try and put down some of the base green color here. And you really want to get that up into the recesses of the engine. If it gets underneath a little bit, that's okay, because we're eventually going to bring this dark glow a little bit out from the engine rather. So I'm going to wipe the other side out. If you ever spray a little bit too much paint and you feel like you messed up, or you feel like it's going to spider on you, you just literally want to back off, and it depends on how much you put down already, but back off and just use the air from your brush to literally try and an almost quick dry the base that you've put down. You see, now what I'm doing is I'm going to try to get this engine glow a little bit up around the mouth of the engine. I'm going to do the same thing on this side. At this stage, it's okay if you cover up a little bit of your edge highlighting.
Let's see here. Because... we're gonna fix that right after the machine. So now we can go on pretty heavy with our greens. Alrighty. So our first color of our glow is done there. The next color is going to be Dark Angel's Green, or Dark Green from Vallejo. Game color. Our Dark Green. Now this is going to be a much more focused go. This, we really want to center this around where you feel the energy is going to be coming from. So that's going to be pretty much dead up and down the center. And almost immediately, maybe not on the camera, but almost immediately from my perspective, I can see a very large color change. But also, you can remember that the paint is very, very well watered down. So you can be pretty pretty overbearing in your application, and still it won't change your color up too much. So we're gonna go nice and wide now at the center. On this side, same thing for the opposite. Then we want to get the weapon mouth as well. But focus, try to really focus this color on the center of the barrel, because that's where we're going to bring a glow out of. Again, we're gonna do the engines on the Tiger Shark there. And I'm going to use... now I'm actually just gonna do this very, very carefully. You wanna work this green right up the middle. And I'll still use my finger as a bit of a mask. But this is really gonna start to bring out this engine glow. And I'm just gonna tint a little bit further out with this dark green. I'm also gonna be giving it a highlight right along the edge where the engine will be hottest. I might actually even go back afterwards with Caliban Green and tone the outside down again. So we're just going to use our fingers, a little bit of a mask. And you're going to want to just start building up that green again. And as before, I'm going to bring it up around the outside edge a little bit. Sorry if you get a little glow over here as well. Bring it up around the outside of this. Alright. Put the Tiger Shark to the side. As before. And now, this color, when we... actually, we're going to move up to Warpstone Glow. And so this is going to be the color that we're not going to thin down as much as the rest, but that also means that you're going to have to be much more focused. So we're going to get a nice dollop of our Warpstone Glow into it. And that's going to be the very dead center of our barrel up here. Oh yeah, and immediately.
we see this color start to go here. Very tip of the weapon knife. Third level of on-source lighting, if you will. Take your time here to bring the very, very edge of this, center edge of this thing up to color. Then we'll give the front of our barrel now quite a bit of glow. On to the next one. Just continue. And this is going to go just literally on the inner edge of the weapon mouth. Final step is going to be pure white with no green added. Touch up on all of these colors real quick.
Okay. I'm going to spray a very singular line. Now I'm just going to go back with a bit of moot green and add a highlight to a couple places just to give us back some of our nice green. As you can see, I'm just going along the outward edge of the engine with a very, very thin down moot green. Just give it a nice bit of glow in there. Same with this side. We want to kind of lift the green back up to a nice... And so, as you can see, with that last step, I completed the weapon glow on the engines and the railguns. Alright guys, that was my first video tutorial. Thanks for watching. Be safe.